Crazy.
Gone.
Really is.
Boy, the story I heard about the tornado that really got me was a guy in Kansas, I think. He had a tornado shelter and he thought that he was quiet, so he opened up the door and looked up into the center of a tornado. And it was dark, black, except there was lightning going across it like that. And then he immediately shut the door and lived to tell the tale. But apparently they're hollow in the middle.
Oh, yeah, the eye.
Of a tornado? I never, you know, anyway, it's a very small eye.
I have a tornado story. I was driving east across North Dakota, and through the to the north, the sky was really it was sunny, but to the south, the sky was black. And up in the sky, dancing in the sky, were three tornadoes. You could see them. You could see the cone, and they were just sort of dancing there. And they never touched down. But just to complete the atmosphere, so I was driving an AMC Gremlin, and it will go 95 miles an hour, and I can tell you that because I had my foot to the floor. Was going 95 miles an hour, but the most unusual part of the story was I was listening to an AM radio station, which was the only thing I could find, a top 40 radio station, and suddenly Gordon Lightfoot's Race Among the Ruins came on. And if you know that song at all, if you think about that song in connection with the scene that I just painted, it was kind of like Twilight Zone. I think it happened, but
And that little gremlin would have taken off like a paper airplane.
it was a frog, and it wasn't bad enough. I had to have it had to be dark green.
Hi, Marianne. Hi, Gaia.
right, kids, we have gone live on YouTube at
And
this
so
time.
it's up to me to say, sisters and brothers, welcome to like the 105th, I think, consecutive virtual Catbird Cafe. Today's suggestion is, glad to have all you talented people aboard and all you legumes in the peanut gallery and YouTubers out in, on YouTube. We hope you enjoy the show. Our suggested themes today include, just like last week, it's Women's History Month. It's still Women's History Month. It is National Panda Day. It's Everything You Do Is Right Day. And of course, faith in Begorra. It's St. Patrick's Day tomorrow. I've been, been honing my shillelagh for this day ever since last year. Bless me lucky charms.
And
But
just so then, folks, we've got some new folks joining us today, and want to make sure that we emphasize to them that we come up with these themes for each week, and they're for fun, and they're not in any way expected to conform to them unless you want one.
I hardly ever do any of the suggested themes. I won't do anything today because 3 days ago in the gym, I cracked one or two ribs, freak accident. So that was fun, and that will yeah, and it hurts.
I was gonna say,
And
can you
there's
still
nothing
laugh?
I can, what?
Can you still laugh?
No.
Yep, and I can cough, but I can't take a deep breath.
I was
It
gonna
only
say, as they say, it only hurts when I breathe.
That's right.
Stop breathing.
Yep, that was the very day I talked with you, Marianne. Right after our conversation, went down to the gym and hit, broke my rib. Gosh. All right. We want to remind everybody to have their sound for musicians on, and to please mute yourselves while other people are performing. Glenn Gardner is first today, then Mike Delaney, then Betty and Andy. So you know what's coming in the immediate future. Let's start with Glenn, who is
Hey,
from
Glenn.
my hometown originally and now living in Arizona, along with Mark and Cowboy Rex. We hope to have them all playing at Musicians for the Greater Good concert sometime later this year.
I'm in.
All right. It's good to see you, my friend.
Good to see you too. Sorry about the ribs. I did that a couple of years ago, and that is a big ouch.
It goes 6 weeks anyway, and there's nothing they can do about it. They used to tape your lung. You used to tape you, but people got pneumonia from it.
They don't do
So,
anything.
yeah. Well, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Ladies and germs.
Allegedly.
Which
Allegedly,
causes
according to Nietzsche.
Yeah.
causes me
Put
to
your hands
brain
together,
activity.
please, for Mr. Grant Gardner.
Thank you guys. So I'm gonna start, I'm just gonna do a really old James Taylor song here, just because. Something in the way she moves looks my way or calls my name. Seems to leave this troubled world behind. If I'm feeling down and blue, troubled by some foolish game. Always seems to make me change my mind. I feel fine anytime she's around me now. She's around me now. Almost all the time. If I'm well, you can tell she's with me now. She's been with quite a long, long time, and I feel fine. Every now and then, the things I lean on lose their meaning. Find myself careening into places where I should not let me go. Has the power to go, no one else can find me. Silently remind me of the happiness in good times. I know, you know, just gotta know that isn't what she's got to say. How she thinks of where she's been. To me, the words are nice the way they sound. Like to hear them best that way. Doesn't much matter what they mean. Says them mostly just to calm me down. I feel fine anytime she's around me now. Around me now, almost all the time. If I'm well, you can tell she's with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time. Yes, and I feel. Thank you, guys. The
I do
first
believe
one.
Stephen was singing that to Kathy.
Because she's around me now just about all the time.
Aren't you the lucky one?
I'm the lucky
Such
one.
a hopeless romantic. Safari Steve.
You saw that.
I saw that.
That was my name at the Wildlife Center. I was the public educator.
I loved it.
Okay.
All right, and now for something completely different. This one was covered by Bananarama and was originally done by, I think they were a Swedish band called Shocking Blue, so. hottest on a mountain top, was burning like a silver flame, summit of beauty and love, and Venus was her name. She's got it, yeah baby, she's got it. Well, I'm your Venus, I'm your fire at your desire. Well, I'm your Venus, I'm your fire at your desire. Her weapons were her crystal eyes, making every man go mad. Black as the dark night she was, got what no one else had. She's got it, yeah baby, she's got it. Well, I'm your Venus, I'm your fire at your desire. Well, I'm your Venus, I'm your fire at your desire. Baby, she's got it. Well, I'm your Venus, I'm your fire, your desire. Yeah, I'm your Venus, I'm your fire, your desire.
Great.
I love
Thank banana. You guys.
Yeah. Thank you. Glenn Gardner, ladies and gentlemen.
It's just awesome.
Very cool.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Mike Delaney is next, and then back to back. And then before we hear from Tom Maynard, we'll go to Israel and talk to Jaina. He's got his ukulele there. No, wait. All right. Good.
Mandolin.
Mandolin. Yep.
Mandolini.
Oh, Mike.
Mandolini.
Go,
right.
Mike. Go, Mike.
Remember that song, Mandolin Wind?
Yeah, I'm not going to play
What?
I'm not going to play that one.
Oh, okay. I thought you said you were.
No.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Mr. Mike Delaney.
All right, Mike. So I got a song for St. Patrick's Day, and then I've got a song that's not for St. Patrick's Day. So there. This is by Steve Earle, Galway Girl. Well, I took a stroll on the old long walk on a day I met a little girl and we stopped to talk of a fine young day And I ask you, friend, what's a fella to do? 'Cause her hair is black and her eyes are blue. And I knew right there we'd be taking a twirl round the Salt Hill Pond with the Galway girl. We were halfway there when the sun came down. Oops. We were halfway there when the rain came down on a day She asked me up to her flat downtown on a fine soft day And I ask you, friend, what's a fella to do? 'Cause her hair is black and her eyes are blue. And I took her hand and I gave her a twirl, and I lost my heart to a Galway girl. I woke up, I was all alone.
with a broken heart and a ticket home. And I ask you now, tell me what would you do if her hair was black and her eyes were blue? 'Cause I've traveled around, been all over this world. Boys, I ain't seen nothing like a Galway girl.
Well done.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, because she was Black Irish.
Yeah. So the second song I wrote during the February album writing month thing for this for my mandolin, my Chopek mandolin, and it goes exactly like this. Hopefully. Sophia, 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 Sophia. I hold you in my hands. I love to feel your curves, the vibrations from your body. You're more than I deserve. Sophia, 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 it's pure heaven to feel ya. I only want to please ya. Sophia, 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 such beautiful music we make together. My hands and your body, a simple closeness of pleasure. Sophia, 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 it's pure heaven to feel ya. I only want to please ya. Sophia, 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 around my neck you hang from a strap. My fingers on your neck, your body in my lap. My pick finds the notes. This can't be a sin. Your vibrations fill the air. You're my precious mandolin. Sophia, 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 it's pure heaven to feel ya. I only want to please ya. Sophia, Sophia, Sophia. That's it.
Yeah. Delaney.
So I don't know if it's obvious, you know, it's my mandolin is the Sophia model of the Chopek mandolin.
Is that true? I like the headstock there.
Yes.
It's unique.
It's wow. Chopek. It's kind of a knockoff of a, you know, what's it, a Gibson? Yeah, but that's it.
Very cool. Sounds great, too.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mike.
All right. Stop recording right now. Boom.
And
we're going to visit Busking Betty and Andy.
There they are.
Otherwise known as Back to Back.
Already for the big day tomorrow.
Yeah. You guys got a gig tomorrow. Yellow.
She's doing it.
No, we don't. We don't have an Irish gig tomorrow.
I just went over and stole Mike's mandolin.
there you go.
So you get to stay home and have some green beer. All right, folks, it is my pleasure to introduce Betty and Andy, a.k.a. Back to Back.
All right, we're going to do a couple of Irish tunes. Okay, let me get my...
You never knew we were Irish, did you?
Yeah, I know, Italian Irish. We do have a dog named Seamus O'Reilly.
Seamus O'Reilly.
There's a tear in your eye, and I'm wondering why, for it never should be there at all. With such power in your smile, sure a stone you become, so it's never. teardrop should fall. When your sweet little laughter's like some fairy song, and your eyes twinkle bright as can be, should you laugh all the while, then all other times smile, and I'll smile a smile for me. When Irish eyes are smiling, sure it's like a morning spring.
Leprechaun there and everything. We just noticed that you guys have matching bow ties.
Yeah, matching bow ties.
Yeah, this is the greatest shirt I could find. This one is a lot of fun.
I call this my Irish rap song. Oh, my name is the matter. I'm the leader of the band. Although if you and I deserve the finest in the land, we play at cakes and weddings and at every fancy ball. And when we play a few numbers, we play the match from song. All the drums go bang and the cymbals clang, no one delays away. I'll come and play the open soon, and I'll be proud to play. Fancy, Nancy, choose the flute.
Yay!
Oh, be fun.
Outstanding.
Oh, you guys are so much
back
fun.
Back to back.
Woo! You guys.
That was great.
I think we grew up in an Irish neighborhood in the Southeast, so I
think yeah, we grew up in Southeast, so we
a little
know.
Influence here.
I see.
I'm actually the Italianian. Italian from okay. Mama. Italianian.
All right. Thanks, you guys. That was great.
Thank you very much. All right. Let's go to Israel now. After that, it'll be time for Tom, and then Marianne, and then Neil.
But you said Jaina.
Didn't I say just now that we were going to go to Israel? No.
You probably did. I was reading.
I might not have.
I was reading a message. So.
Oh, okay.
Here we are.
There she is.
You said it. You weren't listening.
Right. All right. Thank you.
I know. It's rare. I know.
And how are you? You've been worse.
been worse, been better. No news.
Such is life.
Yeah.
And you are obviously not Irish. But,
no.
Well, what's the weather like?
What's the weather like? High of 70, low of 50. Welcome to what passes for spring.
Yeah, it doesn't sound bad to me. And for the folks listening in here, what time of the day is it there?
You changed your clocks. We didn't. It's
okay.
12:30.
Okay, that's so early for you.
Which is why I'm relatively awake.
Yes.
Right. Yeah. Very good.
Oftentimes, folks, she's here at like 3 a.m. her time. Got to hand it to her.
No, by then, I've moved to. I've pinned the YouTube page to the browser to watch in the morning.
Okay, good.
Yep.
All right. Well, thank you, my dear.
Yeah. Thanks
for the music.
Many blessings.
See you next week.
Yes, hopefully.
And to you.
Now, Tom.
Tom? It's Tom, yes.
Tom.
Who?
There he is.
Who? Right there. Who? Tom.
Who?
Tom, terrific.
Who?
And his
Mighty Wonder Dog Manfred.
Mighty Manfred the Wonder Dog, yes. Right.
Oh, I thought you were commenting on the belly. It's Tom and his belly.
I wouldn't comment on anybody's belly. All right, folks. Let's hear it for Mr. Tom Maynard.
There you go.
Tom. Go, Tom.
Thank you. I've been doing a lot of online stuff, and the sound always seems different every single time. So I'm hoping I'm not overwhelming everybody with overall volume and the balance is okay.
Yeah, I think your balance is fine.
Okay, great. So we're going to start off with a sort of medley thing. I like to introduce one of my own songs with O'Carolan, excuse me, instrumental. So I think this is O'Carolan's draft. And but it leads into my song, Whispers in the Wind. And it always falls apart at the last minute. Where is it? There it is. Thank you. We'll just leave that there.
Not a pretty good.
Deep in the dark and ancient wood, through the mist and through the mire, at the feet of the sacred mountains old, in a clearing burns a fire. The fire consumes all in its reach, tended by their hands unseen. It burns with a crystal and claret light, with the forest verdant green. Paces in the shadows, whispers in the wind, certain that you've seen them, then they're gone again. Edge of vision flicker and fly, the less you see, the more you try. The more you try, they'll pass you by. Whispers in the wind, whispers in the wind. Promise conjured in smoke and flames, wishes whispered in the wind, passions pursued come home again, lie broken in hearts within. Eyes of a child, we take them in, or so like a child it seems. How quickly does desire fade, soon lost, found just in dreams. Faces in the shadows, whispers in the wind, certain that you've seen them, then they're gone again. Edge of vision flicker and fly, the less you see, the more you try. The more you try, the pass you by. Whispers in the wind, whispers in the wind. Forget-me-nots grow wild around, path leads deep which long we sought, but memory fails to mark the place we pass by without a thought. Faces in the shadows, whispers in the wind, certain that you've seen them, then they're gone again. Edge of vision flicker and fly, the less you see, the more you try, the more you try, the pass you by. Whispers in the wind, whispers in the wind, whispers in the wind.
That's great. Wonderful.
Oh, really?
I really wish I could pull off that O'Carolan piece beforehand. That's...
Yeah. Because O'Carolan Caroline was.
I lose it in the middle.
You did real good.
You
I thought.
Great. You did
sounded
great.
Good. He's the Irish Beethoven, or maybe somebody else.
It was very nice, Tom.
Yes, it was.
He's so, been dead a long time. He's not going to care.
Let me get tuned here and get the second one in. This is a Gordon Lightfoot. Sorry about that. Pussy willows, cattails, soft wind and roses, rain pools in the woodland, water to my knees, shivering, quivering, the warm breath of spring. Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses. Catbirds in cornfields. Did I already do that? Daydreams purr together, riding on the roadside. The dust gets in your eyes, reveling, disheveling, the summer night can bring. Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses. Slanted rays in colored days, stark blue horizons, naked limbs and wheat bins, hazy afternoons, voicing, rejoicing, the wine cups to bring. Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses. Harsh nights and candlelights, wood fires ablazing, soft lips and fingertips resting in my soul, treasuring, remembering the promise of spring. Pussy willows, cattails, soft winds and roses.
Beautiful voice, beautiful guitar.
Yeah, thanks.
A beautiful man.
Much appreciated.
Thank you, Tom. Marianne is next, and then Neil, and then I'm going to call on John, who's lurking there in the shadows, and he's apparently a legume tonight, but we'll see. And how are you, m'lady?
I'm good, thank you.
Good, looking good. okay, folks, this woman needs no introduction, but I'm gonna introduce her anyway. It's Marianne McAllister.
All right.
Hello, hello. Well, I got an Irish thing. So this is a Jimmy McCarthy song. It's not as old as I thought it was. It's written in 1984. I first heard it on a Lorena McKennitt. And I thought she just did old stuff, so okay. Anyway, it's a guy's song. I'm thinking, that's a girl's song. Anyway. It's called Ride On.
Finest horse I've ever seen, stands 16, one or two, with eyes wild and green. And you ride the horse so well, hands light to the touch. I could never go with you, no matter how I wanted to. See you. I could never go with you no matter how I wanted to. Ride on, see you. I could never go with you no matter how I wanted to. Into the night without a trace behind, run your claw along my gut one last time. I turn to face an empty space where once you used to lie, and look for a spark that lights the dark through a teardrop in my eye. Right on, see you. I couldn't go with you no matter how I wanted to. Right on, see you. I could never go with you no matter how I wanted to.
I made some Guinness cakes. They're done. One of those has been back and forth.
What was the name of that, Marianne?
Huh?
What was the name of that one?
Ride On, and it's R-I-D-E, not R-I-G-H-T.
R-I-D-E.
Oh, okay.
Right on.
It's by Christy Moore. Christy Moore is the author of the song.
Beautiful song.
No, Christy Moore sang it first. But Jimmy McCarthy actually wrote it.
Oh, thank you. I thought he wrote it.
Yeah, no, he didn't. He didn't. Just Jimmy McCarthy, M-A-C, capital C-A-R-T-H-Y.
It's a great song. God.
It's a cool song. Yeah.
Beautiful dynamics, Mary.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I just love the melody.
That's absolutely beautiful. It was hauntingly beautiful. It's one of the best songs I've ever heard you do. Incredible. Yeah.
And a little sad around the edges.
Yeah. Just a bit, yeah. But it's got a horse in it.
Yes, yay.
That's right, Lisa. So anyway, I made these cakes, and I wish I lived closer to people, because I got 5.5 bottles, I just told Glenn, of Guinness left over. And I thought, you know what, I'm buying it. And I thought, I've made Guinness brownies before, it's been years. And I thought, I'll make this cake. And I'm looking at it, and it says chocolate with fruit overtones and caramel. And I thought, well, how good is that? So I measured the half cup of it, and I've obviously got a 3-inch head on it. And I thought, well, if that's good, I can just eat the head. And gosh, that stuff's awful.
Oh, it's yummy.
No, I even tried the beer. It tastes just like the beer, or just with stout.
Yeah, not so much.
It's an acquired taste.
Yeah.
So there's 3.5 bottles of beer on my wall. They wouldn't let me buy just one.
Right.
They'll do that. So next song is actually, in a way, kind of the same song, but just told. Same story told in a different way. Gordon Mills, Les Reed wrote this 1965. Oh, what a year old. Surprised this wasn't my first word. No, it's not unusual. The audience wants to do the
da 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 da. It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. But when I see you hanging about with anyone, it's not unusual to see me cry. I wanna die. It's not unusual to go out at any time. Ba-da-da-da-da. But when I see you out and about, it's such a crime. And if you ever wanna be loved by anyone, it's not unusual, it happens every day. No matter what you say, you'll find it happens all the time. Love will never do what you want it to. Why can't this crazy love be mine? To find out I'm in love with you.
There, one did it, one of them.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The incredible Mary Ann McAllister.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Just wow. Okay, so Neil is next. And then we'll talk to John, and then it'll be Mark.
Nice. Here's Neil.
Hey, Neil.
Hey, Neil.
The cover to his book is behind him there.
Yeah.
Zooming through space. Have you ever heard the phrase tiny blue pearl?
Maybe.
Like,
reference
to what Earth looks like from a distance.
Blue marble, I've heard.
Tiny blue marble, that's it. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was thinking that'd be a nice name for a band, which I'm hoping to start.
It would, your band, in fact.
Yes. Right. Perfect.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's Neil Dale.
This is about power, internal and external, and a history of the Industrial Revolution. We used to keep our houses warm by burning logs at night. We filled our lamps with whale oil to cast a little light. Our sailors crossed the rolling sea safe in their wooden hulls and sang their lonely shanties to the herrings and the gulls. We powered an economy that ran on wood and sails and sacrificed our forests in nearly all the whales. But horses pulled our carriages and made our wagons roll till industry pushed onwards, run by steam and coal. The whales that made it through were saved by Pennsylvania oil, and overnight petroleum came gushing from the soil. And mothers shook their fists at all cars rushing by and taught their kids to look both ways and not up at the sky. Their men folks left the horses, traded feed bags for a wrench. Pretty soon they'll have a Tesla and a laptop on the bench, 'cause gasoline and diesel took us pretty far, but you can drive around the world in your electric
thunder clouds, and dinosaurs and rocket ships and anything that's loud. Some grow up to be engineers, still dreaming of that fire, and they won't quit until they put the sun inside a jar. But then their sons will want to put a colony on Mars, and maybe then they'll want to shoot a rocket at the stars. But wiser hearts say power has somewhere else to go, and the energy inside us is meant to help us grow. Aborigines will tell you, and the Lakota too, that the undiscovered country is right inside of you. That's where you'll find adventure, that's where the challenge lies, and that's how we will talk to our neighbors in the skies. Let's leave fusion and uranium behind with other toys, and offer real adventures to our little girls and boys. And you won't wake up the chickens with that gutsy Harley roar, but with the sun for your power, you don't need more.
It's true. Yeah. It's absolutely true. the name of Neil's book, by the way, is Who is the Earth? And it's available online, and I recommend it highly.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, I do write a lot of songs about the earth. This one is no exception. This is called Arms Around Us All. It's kind of like earth looking at us like a mother looks at her children who are fighting and can't figure out who started it and really doesn't care. When I got home, I shut the door. When I got home, I shut the door. I really couldn't take much more. My kids were jumping on the floor. Then my cell phone rang. Somewhere far away from me, an old opossum in a tree. He's hunkered down so peacefully, gazing at us all. We're all in this together. Every elm and elephant, every human too. We shout and fight and disagree. It's them that's always wrong, not me. Our mother waiting patiently, arms around us all. Build another shopping mall, big McMansion growing tall, drive a super highway through it all. But little root ends meet and touch, and tiny microbes eat their lunch, and fungus weaves a world around them underneath us all. We're all in this together. Every crow and coconut, every human too. We shout and fight and disagree. It's them that's always wrong, not me. Our mother waiting patiently, arms around us all. And if your life is just a bore, each day means 100 more. Your cares are caught in cubicles and screens. Somewhere on the open sea, a dolphin's jumping, swimming free. She's swimming upside down, blowing bubbles at us all. We're all in this together. Every loon and liverwort, every human too. We shout, fight, and disagree. It's them that's always wrong, not me. Our mother waiting patiently, arms around us all. They're trying to hype another war. Everybody's keeping score. You've got to make someone to hate to be worth fighting for, like China. But when I want to criticize
criticize, I find that I can lift my eyes and watch a golden eagle soaring high above us all. Oh, we're all in this together. Every cow and cottonwood, every human too. Shout and fight and disagree. It's them that's always wrong, not me. Our mother waiting patiently, arms around us all. We humans think we do it all. Emails, x-rays, iPhones, call. Compared to Mother Earth, it isn't much. She makes the air, she breathes for you. She grows your heart that beats into. What was it that you said? We do, proud about it all. We're all in this together. Every fish and frog and fern and every human too. We shout and fight and disagree, but maybe someday we will see our mother waiting patiently underneath us all. High above us all. Great song. Great. Oh, really? I love that song.
Nice.
Conscience of the world. Neil Dale. Excuse me. And yeah, I'm glad you mentioned fungus. People just don't understand what a grand role fungus has in our survival.
That's amazing.
And then also, you know, I think we deserve a spanking by Mother Earth. Yeah.
Well, as long as she spanks you, not me, that's okay.
Okay.
I don't think we can decide on who deserves it. Anyway, never mind.
Yeah. And or who started it.
Yeah.
I think she is.
Because original sin, maybe? I don't know. But anyway, that's Neil Dale. Let's give it up again. Yeah. All right. John Boy is next. It'll be Mark and Storm and Bob.
Hey, John.
Hi there.
Hi. I'm not singing. I'm just just here as a peanut tonight. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm doing better and better. I knew that I was late, but I knew that the show would be entertaining tonight, and Betty and Andy did not disappoint.
No. Super. Yeah. I mean, everybody's been great so far.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
And we miss you, but we're glad you're aboard here. I miss you, and for one thing, you know, nobody else will laugh at my stupid jokes.
Well, I'll keep laughing.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. Yeah, it's a great group.
What's going on in John?
Man of charity, John.
Yeah. Well, I was moving stuff out of Dad's house the other day, and I twisted my back. So, if I sit for a long time, it gets kind of uncomfortable. So. Yeah. May not be here for the whole night, but it's almost back to where it should be now. So,
yeah. Well, it's not that I don't feel bad for you, but I'm sitting here all night and I broke my ribs three days ago in the gym. It was a stupid accident.
Oh no! Oh,
but it hurts.
I bet.
If I can do it, damn it, you can do it.
All right, you're an inspiration.
Gosh, and John, even though he didn't sing, he deserves applause. That's John McHugh.
Oh,
yeah.
Thanks,
and
everybody.
John also is, you know, keeps an eye on what's going on in YouTube for us, and we appreciate that.
Yeah, that's I shared that on YouTube. Yeah, so, and is Jay here? Yeah, Jay showed up, right?
Yeah, Jay's here.
There he is.
He's okay. Here, and
everyone's here.
Somebody, is Paul Clark here?
No, he hasn't shown. He hasn't.
Okay, because he said he was going to sign up, but it was too late, and I don't know. He might show up.
And Jay is
with Jay's here, and he's number 10.
Number 10, okay. Very good. Right. Thanks, John.
Thanks, John.
Thank you.
Mark on.
Glad you're here.
Bye bye.
Hey.
Mark. That's a dog with a hair lip.
It is.
Mark.
Yeah. Mark.
Thank you, John.
There's the laugh.
Oh, my. Well, it's good to see you, my friend.
Yeah.
It's good to be seen as opposed to being viewed, of course.
Right. Yeah, well, in addition to that, and your fingers are working good. And
your arms.
Yeah, things are coming along. The arms getting back into shape, and I've another 4 weeks, and I'll probably be normal again. So,
all right,
as normal as I get. So.
Yeah, which is not very. But that's one of the things we love about you.
Right.
Yeah.
Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, for Mark Bishop Evans.
Softly she comes, whispers the breeze with her passing. In secret love, she is laughing. Softly she comes in the night. Softly she sighs, sweetly she lies, never sleeping. Her fragrance all in my keeping. Softly she comes in the night. Down the darkened hall, I hear her footsteps on my stair. Then she is in my arms once more. Then softly she goes, her shining lips in the shadow. Whispers goodbye at my window. Softly she goes in the dawn. Down the darkened hall, I hear her footsteps on my stairs. Then she is in my arms once more. But softly she goes, her shining lips in the shadow. Whisper goodbye at my window. Softly she goes in the dawn.
Beautiful, beautiful job. Yeah.
something at the other end of the spectrum. Hey, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How about cooking something up with me? Hey, hey, you sweet baby, don't you think maybe we could find a brand new recipe? I got a hot rod Ford and a $2 bill, and I know a spot right over the hill. Soda pop and the dancing is free. If you want to have some fun, come along with me. Hey, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How about cooking something up with me? I'm free and ready, so we can go steady. How about spending all your time with me? No more looking, you know I've been tooking. How about spending steady company? I'm gonna throw my date book over the fence, find me one for 5 or 10 cents. Keep it till it's covered with age. You're gonna write your name down at every page. Hey, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How about cooking something up with me? $2 bill. I know a spot right over the hill. Soda pop and the dancing is free. If you want to have some fun, come along with me. Hey, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How about cooking something? How about cooking something? How about cooking something up with me?
Well done, wow. Sid. Ah, real, real good. I'm so glad to have you back. Who wrote that? Does anybody know?
Hank Williams.
Hank Williams. Hank Thank Williams. You, Jay.
1951.
Yep. I think what's cooking is Guinness cake.
Yes. Yeah, we don't get any, though. maybe she can send some in the mail. All right, thank you, Mark. Bishop Evans.
Great to have you back.
All right, it's Storm next, and then Cowboy Bob, and then Jay Cunningham. So
she could pay for it to just have a very expensive Uber drive.
That's right. You consider that, Marianne? Oh, nice hat.
Good hat.
I like it. Yeah. How are you?
I've had better weeks. Yeah, it's not been a fun week. We've been on a 10-day countdown to see whether Mariah had COVID from direct exposure by a staff member. Meanwhile, she has a bruise beside her eye that nobody knows how she got. I went to a appointment with a specialist on Monday about my arm, and my lovely health center hadn't sent any records, so the appointment couldn't be conducted.
Geez, what's up with our healthcare system?
Oh, and I think I told you, I think I was on here last Saturday, so you got that news, which is, you know, still in the same week that they pulled you know, I was not delusional about that, at least. And I really did did have parts of a stitch and a knot in my head still. And I'm still not convinced they got everything.
It takes a while for stuff like that to heal.
Yep. Well, it's just there's a piece that still feels like it could be a stitch in the side of my head.
it might just be healing thing. I had one of those in my lip. I thought that there was a sliver in there for weeks, but it was just my lip was healing.
Yep.
So stay positive.
Yeah, I am doing that to the best of my abilities, that's for sure.
All right, sisters and brothers, it's the one and only Storm.
And I'm going to take you to both ends of the spectrum. The first piece I'm doing is a slightly heavy piece in honor of Women's International Rights Month. Political non-cooperator. Another week passes and she remains in jail. Another week passes and yet another and she remains in jail. How much longer will we have to wait for true words, hear encapsulated reports and rumors? Another week passes and she remains in jail. Another week passes and she remains in jail, refusing to give her name, to accept food, to walk or follow orders. All this for a country that doesn't desire to be saved. All this because we love the land. All this because we are the earth's children and she does not belong to us. Another week, how many more times will steel doors close? How many more of us will choose to lose our freedom? For how long? Because we are seeking to change the world. Another week passes and yet another, and she remains in jail. It's time to thank the women who've helped to form our lives. Time to celebrate them as workers, lovers, wives. It's time to thank the women for all that they have done. Time to give them credit and their place beneath the sun. So thank you, Nancy, Jessica, Pamela, Grace, for the strength of your healing embrace. And thank you, Juanita, Rana, Kalinda, and Chase. We're glad you're all part of this race. We're grateful you've labored and mothered so long. We're grateful you've taught us to dare to hold on. We're grateful you're fighters, marchers, and writers who struggled to get us to here. We're grateful you're teachers, midwives, and weavers, and women of every career. It's time to thank the women who've helped to form our lives. Time to celebrate them as workers, lovers, wives. It's time to thank the women for all that they have done. Time to give them credit and their place beneath the sun. Yes, thank you, Lily, Sweet Fawn, Amanda, and Sue, for the caring and sharing you do. And thank you, Nisa, Nicole, Muriel, Lonnie Drew. The world's truly brightened by you. It's time to thank the women who've helped to form our lives. Time to celebrate them as workers, lovers, wives. It's time to thank the women for all that they have done. Time to give them credit and their place beneath the sun. It's time to thank the women who've helped to form our lives. Time to celebrate them as workers, lovers, wives. It's time to thank the women for all that they have done. Time to give them credit and their place beneath the sun.
Yeah. Thank you, women. Every one of you.
And my second piece, as I said, is a lot lighter, Irish themed. And I have one poem that I wrote that sounds like it should be an Irish blessing, but I wrote it. A blessing for every day. May you experience a day to remember. May God's love help you to grow. May God's light shine bright in your eyes. May you give with the aid of its glow. And I wrote the poem and song that I did as the first piece. And this is not, this is author unknown, traditional Irish, or I guess maybe just author unknown. Oh, the other night I got an invitation to a funeral, but to me disappointment, the bugger didn't die. So to ease our disappointment, he took us out and treated us, and seen as he apologized, we let the thing go by. To ease our disappointment, he took us out and treated us. He bought a quart of ale for a company of 10. When some of us asked him whose money he was squandering, the fellow took out his wallet. We never asked again. Now we got a concertina for to aid in the rascality, but none of us could play it, though we sought to, though, wait, sorry. Now we got a concertina for to aid in the rascality, but none of us could play it, though we did our best and worst. We made an awful noise, and if it's any benefit, we played the thing so carefully that all the bellows burst. We got a boiled potato for to mend the concertina with when someone hit Maloney with the carcass of a cat. He bottled up his whiskers and he read out the riot act. He swore he'd put two hits upon the bastard who did that. When the owner of the beer shop, he saw us all rioting, he gave orders to get out, but at that we all refused. So he whistled in some loafers that was standing around the corner, and for 10 or 15 minutes we was bodily abused. When we left the beer shop, on down the road we started with a bunch of hungry urchins. They pelted us with mud. We told them to chuck it. They said that they were doing that, and then they all ran off, and they left us where we stood. Well, the next thing we got was a bunch of Salvationers. They rifled all our pockets, and they asked us where we saved. Poor little John McGinty got escorted to the station house for asking a great policeman if his appetite was shaved. Oh, for to free McGinty, we then took off our undershirts and down to the pawn shop we took the blooming lot. We told him that we only wanted 10 and 6 on them. There's enough on them already, was the answer that we got. Yeah, we got our 10 and 6, all for to free McGinty with. Bad luck was the beer shop that we passed along the way. For of course we couldn't pass it without having some refreshment, and we squandered all the money of the fine we had to pay. Now the drink being in us, the sense it was all out of us, and for a bit of rioting we quickly did repair. We battered one another till we all weren't worth 3 halfpennies. You could have carpeted the floor with all the skin and hair. For McCarty hit Mahoney, and Mahoney hit some other man, and every man hit any man against he had a spite. poor old McNamara, who was sitting saying nothing, got a kick that broke his jaw for not indulging in the fight. We fought away like Turks until the policemen separated us. They took us to the jail with broken noses and black eyes. I got 60 days in prison, and it was a lesson, sure. I'll go no more to funerals until the bastard dies.
Nice, Storm.
That would be Storm, ladies and gentlemen. Storm. They broke the mold. Yes, they did. Thank you, my friend. All right. Cool. Upcoming, we got Bobby Vello, Jay Singing Spirit Cunningham, and Emily Keenan. I think that would be, is that how I pronounce it? Keenan?
Keenan, Keenan.
One way to unmute yourself is just press the space bar.
Yeah, it's Kinnan.
Kinnan. Okay, thank you.
Thanks, Eileen.
I won't make that mistake again. But in as much as Cowboy Bob is next, why don't we let Beverly Dixon introduce him, because she's the president of the Cowboy Bob fan club.
Yes, she is. Wait a minute, though. Yeah. I've got to put...
Hi, guys.
Hi, Bev.
Hey, Beverly. What are you doing?
I want to share the spotlight.
I want to wish everybody a happy St. Patrick's Day with my new little friend, Seamus.
I love him.
Oh, I love it.
Yes, you should say.
I'm over a four-leaf clover. I want to introduce the world's most wonderful performer, my friend, yes. Bobby Vello, and everybody needs to go out and buy his new CD. That's all.
Yes.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you, Beverly.
All right.
Thank you, Beverly.
Thanks, Bev. Thanks. Well, coincidentally, I'm going to do a couple of songs from Blue Streak, which is the CD that Beverly was referring to. So this is, it's called The Company of Strangers. Oh, wait a minute, this will never do. I've got a great big picture of myself on the screen. Uh-uh. I want to see all you folks.
He's a humble man.
No, I just want to see who's making fun of me behind my back. Company of Strangers. How's that guitar sound? Is that that level seem reasonable?
Maybe a little hot. What do you think, Tom?
That's okay to me.
Can't hear you.
That's okay to me.
Sounds good to him.
Oh, okay.
Okay, here we go. Company of Strangers. I prefer the company of strangers. Like the folks you find in the moonlight of a small town barroom. On the westbound train, when the shadows tell you night time, coming soon. I prefer the company of strangers. Hope they'll be around when the sun shines. Around for good times. When cold rain falls, you know they won't be found. Yet still, I'm like an old friend, they can't let you down. Black Hills. It's I will ride. as new times arrive, new girls unite. Maybe she'll love me, just don't see it wrong. I'm here for the evening, gone with the morning light. I'm a windows roll down, the air is cool and green. Moonlight on snowfall, got some time to dream. I left no one behind, waiting by the phone for my call. Tonight I drive, tomorrow I ride. I will write. It's a new time tomorrow, new girl tonight. Maybe she'll love me, just don't seem right. I'm here for the evening, gone with the morning light. Stampede, I'm a little shy. Sunlight on the mountains just might be some time. It's in my soul, it's in my blood. Leave my all in the best I can. Six times in big money, 600 in the ball. It's a new time tomorrow, new girl tonight. Maybe she'll love me, just don't seem right. I'm here for the evening, gone with the morning light.
Jay is next, and then Emily, and then Rich. And Jay writes, I got some Celtic tunes to warm your wee little hearts. And you're all greened up.
Yeah.
Okay. Put them together, please, for Jay, singing spirit.
Thank you, thank you. Okay. You all know this song, so... when I say no, nay, never, everybody clap. I've been
a wild rover for many a year. And I spent all me money on whiskey and beer. And now I'm returning with gold in great store. And I never will play the wild rover no more. Somebody's unmuted. He was unmuted. Okay, I'll start again. If you don't mind. I've been the wild rover for many a year. And I spent all me money on whiskey and beer. And now I'm returning with gold in great store. And I never will play the wild rover no more. Well, it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover. No, nay, never, no more. Well, I went to an alehouse I used to frequent. And I told the landlady me money was spent. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. For a custom like yours I can have any day. And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover. In me pocket, pulled out 10 sovereigns bright. And the landlady's eyes opened up with delight. She said, you can have whiskey and wines of the best. And I told her I was only in jest. For it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more will I play wild rover. No, nay, never, no more. Well, I went home to me parents to confess what I'd done, and told them to forgive their prodigal son, and asked them to caress me as once like before. And I never will play the wild rover no more. For it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover.
Favorite of mine, Carrick Fergus. I wish I had you in Carrick Fergus, only for nights in Ballygran. I would swim over the deepest ocean, to be by your side. But the sea is wide, and I can't swim over, and neither I
have wings to fly. I wish I could find me a handsome boatman to carry me over to my love and die. My boyhood friends bring back sad reflection of happy hours, oh, so long ago. My boyhood friends and all my relations have all passed on now, like the melting snow. So I'll spend my day in endless roving. Soft is the grass, and my bed is free. Oh, to be home now in Carrickfergus, on the long road down to the salty sea. And in Kilkenny, it is reported on marble stone, they're as black as ink, with gold and silver. I did support her, but I'll sing no more till I get a drink. I'm drunk today and rarely sober. A handsome rover from town to town. But I'm sick now, my days are numbered. Won't all ye young men come and lay me down? I wish I had you in Carrickfergus, only for nights in Ballygran. I would swim over the deepest ocean, the deepest ocean, to be by your side.
Great job.
Thank you.
Wonderful Irish songs. Okay. Jay singing Spirit Cunningham.
Thank you.
Outstanding, Jay. Outstanding, Jay.
Thank you.
And Hope.
Yeah.
Emily is next, and then Rich, and then Val.
And, hi.
Hi. We're at Eileen Cleary's house now, and we have a brand new artist with us today. And please join us in welcoming Emily Kinnon.
Hey, Emily.
I am going to sing a folk song, which aligns with two folk songs, which aligns with what we've been hearing tonight. But it's a little bit more, well, a lot more modern twist on things. I'll just start. We gather here, we line up even in a sunlit end. If I'm on fire, you'll be made of ashes too. Even on my worst day, did I deserve, babe, all the hell you gave me? 'Cause I loved you, I swear I loved you till my dying day. I didn't have it in myself to go with grace, and you're the hero flying around saving face. And if I'm dead to you, why are you at the wake, cursing my name, wishing I stayed? Look at how my tears ricochet. We gather stones, never knowing what they'll need. Some to throw, some to make a diamond ring. You know I didn't want to have to haunt you. What a ghostly scene. You wear the same jewels that I gave you as you bury me up. I didn't have it in myself to go with grace, 'cause when I'd fight you, you used to tell me I was brave. And if I'm dead to you, why are you at the wake, cursing my name, wishing I stayed? Look at how my tears ricochet. And I can go anywhere I want, anywhere I want, just not home. And you can aim for my heart, go for blood, you would still miss me in your bones. And I still talk to you when I'm screaming at the sky. And when you can't sleep at night, you hear my stolen lullabies. And also, I'm just getting over the flu, so I missed that last note. But
well, you know what? It was a great job. Where does that song come from? Whose song was it?
Taylor Swift.
I thought it sounded familiar. Yeah.
Super. And then the second song is by Noah Kahn, this new folk artist, and it's called Stick Season. I just have to adjust something. All right. As you promised me that I was more than all the miles combined, you must have had yourself a change of heart, like halfway through the drive, because your voice trailed off exactly as you passed my exit sign. Kept on driving straight and left our future to the right. Now I am stuck between my anger, blame that I can't face, and memories of something even smoking weed cannot replace. And I am terrified of weather, 'cause I see you when it rains. Doc told me to travel, but there's COVID on the planes. And I love Vermont, but it's the season of the sticks. And I saw your mom, she forgot that I existed, and it's half my fault, but I just like to play the victim. I'll drink alcohol till my friends come home for Christmas. And I'll dream each night of some version of you that I might not have, but I did not lose. Now your tire tracks and one pair of shoes, and I'm split in half. That'll have to do. So I thought that if I piled something good and all my bad, that I could cancel out the darkness I inherited from Dad. No, I am no longer funny, funny, cause I miss the way you laugh. Once called me forever, now you still can't call me back. And I love Vermont, but it's the season of the sticks. And I saw your mom, she forgot that I existed. And it's half my fault, but I just like to play the victim. I'll drink alcohol till my friends come home for Christmas. And I'll dream each night of some version of you that I might not have, but I did not lose. Now your tire tracks and one pair of shoes, and I'm split in half. That'll have to do. Oh, that'll have to do. My other half was you. I hope this pain's just passing through, but I doubt it. And I love Vermont, it's the season of the sticks. And I saw your mom, she forgot that I existed. And it's half my fault, but I just like to play the victim. I'll drink alcohol till my friends come home for Christmas. And I'll dream each night of some version of you that I might not have, but I did not lose. Now your tire tracks and one pair of shoes, and I'm split in half. That'll have to do, have to do.
All right.
Real good.
Yeah. Well done,
Emily Cannon made it.
Thank you. Oh,
that was great.
Thank you.
Thank you for getting on board with us. I hope that you don't be a stranger and remain with the family.
Yeah.
You do that for me?
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Before Rich and Val and Rich and Val come up, we're going to have a word from our sponsor, and then also Paul Clark is with us, and Gaia is not performing this evening because she doesn't feel like it. And
she needs to save her voice.
Yeah, whatever. It's her,
whatever.
You know, if you don't want to sing, it's your choice. And so instead of Gaia, we'll have Paul Clark. Okay, Paul?
And that's right after Val Fowler, Paul.
Right. Sorry. After Val Fowler.
I thought I answered you, but then I realized I didn't send it.
I'm assuming it's all right. And so now, ladies and germs, a word from our sponsor.
I got a spotlight, and here we go. Once again, and as you all know, a large part of why we're here is to support the New England Wildlife Center and the great work and very important work that's going on there right now with all the babies. It's baby season, it's whelping season, it's hatching season, it's everything. So please, as always, we request that if you are able to, if you are willing to, make a donation to newildlife.org. And the donate button is easy to find on that page. Or if you'd prefer to send money over snail mail, it is 500 Columbian Street. That's in South Weymouth, Massachusetts, 02190. And this time of year, there's some really good stories on the Facebook pages for Cape Wildlife and for New England Wildlife Center. The one that charmed me this week was, and sadly, a fox kit that was brought in, a baby fox that was brought into the center, having lost his mom and all his siblings. They were found and they were not alive, but this one little tiny was.
Some Good Samaritans put their gloves on, as they should, and then brought this little guy into the wildlife center, where they were able to save him, and he is surviving. But what happens with a fox kit is that they have to find another one, because at least another one, because foxes are so social, and the only way that they can learn to how to behave and how to survive in the wild is by interacting with other foxes. So they're looking, actually, not that they hope that there's another orphan fox, but if there is one, they would very much like to have them grow up as siblings. So anyway, cool story. Check out the Facebook pages for both centers, the New England Wildlife Center and the Cape Wildlife Center. There's really good stories there. And Tom just mentioned in the chat that they also have an Amazon wish list going right now. And Tom, thank you for donating to that. I saw that you had. So anyway, that's it. That's it for me.
And if you're writing a check, just tell them the catbird sent you.
Yeah, or making the donation online. There's a place where you can say that.
So okay.
Yeah. Appreciate it.
I'm wondering what would happen if we could pair that fox up with a dog pup.
Oh, I don't know. But then how
they're
would he
canines.
Learn? Yeah, know. But how would he learn to be in the wild? I guess he doesn't learn from another infant, but I don't know. A thought.
It's a good point.
Yeah.
Because, you know, chances aren't very good that they're going to find another lone fox out there.
Well, yeah. But last year they had a number of fox kits and they were able to pair some together. So
I did not know that.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. That's Kathy Donlan.
Thank you, everybody.
Couldn't do it without her. Couldn't do anything without her. Oy. Oh, and speaking of oy, Neil Braverman is back in the hospital again. He fell, I think, 5 times. And I know he broke several ribs. I only broke one or two. And he fell again, I guess. And so now he's back in the hospital because he was out and with us last week. So I'm hoping that maybe we can all share a moment of silence here in which we can envision a complete and quick recovery for Neil. Get better, Neil. Thank you.
Yeah.
Rich Barrett is next, then Val Fowler, and then Paul Clark.
And there's Rich Barrett.
Hey, Rich.
Hello.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing fine, for once.
Yeah.
I wonder what would happen if they couldn't find another fox kit with a cat, a little kitten. Because on the outside, you let a cat outside, he hunts.
That's true.
It's true.
The foxes are more closely related to dogs, but that's a good point. Because cats can go out and kill birds all day and all night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good one.
Our hawks are active right now.
We'll recommend that.
All the squirrel nests around.
Oh, there's a million of them. I love baby squirrels. Also, lots of baby raccoons.
The hawks like the baby squirrels, too.
Yeah.
They've been breeding all the nests. We've got a half a dozen more around here in the trees.
Well, there's plenty of squirrels around, and hawks got to eat too.
Yeah. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Rich Barrett.
About as Irish as I get. I don't drink green beer. I do like my Guinness, though. This is John Lennon to him. If you had the luck of the Irish, you'd be sorry and wish you were dead. You should have the luck of the Irish, you'd wish you were English instead. 1,000 years of torture and hunger drove the people away from their land. A land full of beauty and wonder was raped by the British brigand. If you could keep voices like flowers, there'd be shamrocks all over the world. If you could drink dreams like Irish dreams, then the world would be high as the mountains of Moher. In the pool they told us the story, how the English divided the land, of the pain and the death and the glory, and the poets of old Ireland. If we could keep chains with Mountain Dew, the world would be like Galway Bay. Let's walk over rainbows like leprechauns, and the world would be one big Blarney Stone. Why the hell are the English there anyway? And they kill with God on their side. Blame it all on the kids and the IRA, and the bastards commits genocide. You should have the luck of the Irish. You'd be sorry and wish you were dead. You should have the luck of the Irish. You'd wish you were English instead. Yes, you'd wish you were English instead.
A song from the Troubles.
That's a deep cut, boy.
This one I'm going to do a cappella. It's a Harry Chapin song about a time when men were going out west and looking for wives to help them take care of the land that they'd gotten. It's called Mail Order Annie. I'm supposed to have a harmonica, but I broke my D. First I did not think it could be you, but you're the only one that got off the train. So you must be my wife, Miss Annie Halsey, yeah. And I must be your husband, yes, I'm Harry Crane. Mail order Annie, never mind your crying. Your tears are sweet rain in my empty life. Mail order Annie, can't you see I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You are the woman who's come to be my wife. You know you're not as pretty as I dreamed you'd be, but then I'm not no handsome fancy Dan. And out here, looks are really not important, no, no. It's what's inside a woman when she's up against the land. Mail order Annie, never mind your crying. Your tears are sweet rain in my empty life. Mail order Annie, can't you see I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You are the woman who's come to be my wife. You know it's not no easy life you're entering. The winter wind comes whistling through the cracks there in the sod. You know you'll never have too many neighbors. There's you, babe, there's me, and there's God. You know I'm just a dirt man from the North Dakota plains. You're one girl from the city who's been thrown out on her own. And I'm standing here not sure of what to say to you.
except in mail order, Annie, let you and me go home. Mail order, Annie, never mind your crying. Your tears are sweet rain in my empty life. Mail order, Annie, can't you see I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You are the woman who's come to be my wife. I'm Hanukkah usually ends it.
We should do that together sometime. I'll play harmonica.
Very nice.
Thank you. That's Rich Barrett, and Rich, we need to go to the Snug again.
Yeah, not this week.
No, maybe the week after.
Yeah,
Monday night. Yeah, you can bring your ball in. Yeah.
Yeah. Sweet.
Cool.
I'm going to try and do something with the Hammond dulcimer tonight, but it needed tuning.
Oh. I hate when that happens.
That's the, like 36 strings on it.
Yeah.
Yikes.
It's worse than a 12-string guitar.
Yeah.
12-string on a steroid.
All right.
Yes, I would love to go back to the Snug.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We had fun. Next week or the week after.
It's in Hingham, and they have the best shepherd's pie.
They do.
They're going to be mobbed this weekend. Huh?
I can't say much for their bangers and mash, but the shepherd's pie is the best in the world.
That's what you say. Well, the bangers and mash wasn't bad either.
No, they weren't, it wasn't
so
great.
But the bangers were just too so little, you know.
Yeah, but there were plenty of them.
And they weren't bad.
No, they were fine. They were just not as good as the shepherd's pie.
Yeah. All right, let's stumble on here. Val is next, and then Paul, and then Jimmy.
Here's Val.
Hey, Val.
Howdy. Howdy.
How do you do?
Well, I was thinking I would pass my turn and get something to eat after that last discussion.
Oh, yeah. All right. But anyway, you can hold off until after your two songs. Folks, please welcome Val Fowler.
So, Women's History Month. Martha walked right to that dam, a hoe and shovel in each hand. She found to dig for every woman and man and child who was sick with fever. Government men, send me our favorite sons, be a place of worth or somewhere, somewhere, someone. If they drown that valley, the canal boats will come, they ground that lovely valley. But the waters grew black and the sickness came, they hung their heads in grief and shame. She took Martha's said, we've only ourselves to blame. She took up a hammer. She took up a shovel and a hoe, good Lord, she took up a shovel and a hoe. Cause it's time, it's time to take a stand. The whole world set things right, the whole world's waste is in trouble. Never doubt or question the power of love or one woman with a shovel. It's time to take a stand and set things right. The whole world's waste, even trouble. Never doubt or question the power of love or one woman with a shovel. Along came Elizabeth, Sarah, and Rose, Eva, Clara, and Ruth. They came with picks and shovels and hoes, and armed with righteous truth. Then came Calvin, Eli, and Scott, Timothy, David, and Paul. And together before the sun came up, they tore down that cursed wall. Yeah, yeah, tore down that cursed wall. Cause it's time, time to take a stand, set things right. The whole world's way is deep in trouble. Never doubt or question the power. fire of love, or one woman with a struggle. Well, the lake bed, all that path led south, they'd save that wretched land. Not a single juror, St. Jerry, person or judge would think to jail or find them. No, no, would think to jail or find them. Marco walked right down to that dam, a hoe and a shovel in either hand. She was bound to dig for every woman and man, a child who was sick with fever. It's time to take a stand and set things right. The whole world's waist deep in trouble. Never doubt or question power of love. One woman is a struggle. Never doubt or question power of love, or one woman with a shovel. One woman with a shovel.
Oh, great song.
What's it about?
Really appropriate.
It's based on a nice true story, and it was written by Carrie Newcomer.
Good song.
So, I was interested in Tom's duo because I had planned a similar one.
Thank you.
once watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing. We had dreams and songs to sing. Now lonely Isle of Peace about to rise. By a lonely harbor wall, I watched a young girl watch the last star fall. As a prison ship sailed out against the sky, now she'll wait in hope and pray for her love in Botany Bay. Only are the fields of Athenry. So long are the fields of Athenry, where once you watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing. We had dreams songs to sing. How lonely are the fields of Athenry. Our love was on the wing. We had dreams and songs to sing. How lonely are the fields of Athenry.
Well, that was
beautiful. Nice job, Val.
Yeah. Two fine songs.
Yeah.
Val.
Thank you.
Nice, Val.
Hey, this is the first time I've gotten two out of the themes.
All right.
Yay, Val.
Write it down on the calendar.
Okay.
Yes. And then you have many more.
Yeah.
All right. Now, let us paddle across the pond into the misty isle.
It isn't that misty. I don't like to what's the word, shatter your dreams, but there we go.
Not misty, huh?
Not misty. Oh well.
All right, folks, put them together for Mr. Paul Clark.
It's hard to take a name like mine and give it some sort of drama, isn't it? Two like monosyllables, common as muck names. Mm. Anyway, well done, Steve. Great one. Thank you. This is I'm just doing Irish stuff. This is by Percy French, The Mounted Zone, and his musical collaborator, Couston Colliston, who doesn't often get credited to. It's The Mountains of Mourne. Dear Mary, this London's a wonderful sight, with people here working by day and by night. They don't sow potatoes, nor barley, nor wheat, but there's gangs of them digging for gold in the street. At least, when I asked them, that's what I was told. So I took me a hand at this digging for gold. But for all that I found there, I might as well be where the mountains of Mourne sweep down to the sea. I believe that when writing a wish you expressed, to know how the fine ladies of London are dressed. Well, if you believe me, when off to a ball, they don't wear any tops to their dresses at all. I've seen them myself, and I could not by half decide if they were bound for a ball or a bath. Don't be starting them fashions, no Mary McCree, where the mountains of morn sweep down to the sea. I've seen England's king from the top of a bus, and I've never known him, yet he means to know us. Although by the Saxon we once were oppressed, still I cheered, God forgive me, along with the rest. And now that he's visited Erin's green shore, we'll be much better friends than we've been heretofore. When we've got all we want, we're as quiet as can be, where the mountains of morn sweep down to the sea. You remember young Peter O'Loughlin, of course. Well, now he's here at the head of the force. I met him today, I was crossing the Strand, and he stopped the whole street with a wave of his hand. And there we stood talking of days that are gone, while the whole population of London looked on. But for all these great powers, he's wishful, like me, to be back where the dark morn sweeps down to the sea. There's beautiful girls here, oh, never you mind, with beautiful shapes nature never designed. They've lovely complexions, all roses and cream, but let me remark with regard to the same. If at those roses you venture to sip, why the colours might all come away on your lip. So I'll wait for the wild rose that's waiting for me, where the mountains of morn sweep down to the sea. Yes, I'll wait for the wild rose that's waiting for me, where the mountains of morn sweep down to the sea.
Hi.
I love that.
Beautiful.
Nice, Paul.
Funny too.
Yeah, funny too.
Right, and this other one is by Ron Kavanagh, a bit more modern. Probably written, it was written about the what they call the Troubles over there, which are sort of gone away under the surface, I suppose. But and given all the news elsewhere, one of these songs that sadly is still all too relevant, called Reconciliation. When summertime has gone and autumn winds are threatening to blow our love away, 'tis then love will be tested. Arm in arm we'll stand, side by side together, to face the common foe that would tear our love asunder.
Dark December morning, when hard times come around, like cold and stormy weather, there's only you and I, my love, to shelter one another. Tooraloo-ralay, tooraloo-ralanday, tooraloo-ralay, tooraloo-ralay. Now there's a time to fight, and there's a time for cleansing, as the sun will melt the snow on clear, bright April mornings. Our strife has run its course, and these are times for healing. So let us now embrace sweet reconciliation.
That's Paul Clark, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, so glad you joined us tonight, Paul.
Yes, we missed you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been a bit absent, sorry. But
No problem.
You are forgiven. All right. We got Jimmy up next, and then Karen. Then we're going to check in with Jade and Marianne, and then it'll be Cowboy Rex.
Here's Jimmy.
Here's Jimmy. And Jimmy is glad that he is back in the Eastern Standard Time Zone.
It's good to be on your time. 3 o'clock in the afternoon is a tough one when you're in San Diego.
Yeah, this is better.
He's right, adjusting Jimmy. The view here. There.
Is that better? That's, is that not good?
That's good.
It's very good.
All right, folks, all the way from Michigan, it's Jimmy Lunsford. The hell is that? What is that?
I have a prop. I have a prop.
Okay.
Oh, he's itinerant.
Okay.
Yes, itinerant Jimmy.
So Life on the Road, there's only one song that fits this Life on the Road, and it's a classic song, and I didn't realize, but Wikipedia says, so it must be true, it won a gazillion awards when Jimmy Dean sang it back in 1965. And I took the liberty of adding a few lines, a couple verses to give it a little more. It's kind of short, King of the Road. But
yes.
I gave it a couple more lines to lengthen it a little bit, and a couple of which might be relevant to me, which I'm sure you'll get. But I don't know how to play it, so this will be an a cappella shot. But I love this song, just a great song. You could sing this song all day long just walking down the street, which I have done. And then after that, I'll pick up my guitar and play a song. Trailers for sale or rent, rooms to let 50 cents. No phone, no pool, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes, ah, but 2 hours of pushing broom buys a 8x12 four-bit room. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. Third boxcar, midnight train, destination Bangor, Maine. Old worn-out suit and shoes. I don't pay no union dues. I smoke old stogies I have found. Short, but not too big around. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. I know every engineer on every train, all of the children and all of their names. Every handout in every town, and every lock that ain't locked when no one's around. I go Sundays to St. Peter's, listen to the faith leaders, shepherding souls in need. And I wait at the door till their wallets bleed. Then I head to the rectory for all the pancakes that you can eat. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. I walk up and down this granite town, monuments all around, stone faces and memories, the people's house except for me. But I'm living a life I choose, singing and some soft shoe. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. I know every vacancy and everyone from Baltimore West on the B&O run. Every senator from every state and everyone whose word is worth the time of the day. I need some shut eye before too long. It ties the weary and the strong. You can pray for your soul to keep, but you can't do without your sleep. So I'll just lean back with my eyes closed and use my bindle for a pillow. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road.
Well done, sir.
Awesome, Jimmy.
Nice, Jimmy.
Roger Miller's turning over in his grave. Isn't he?
he's rolling over and over and over. He's like, what? All right.
Oh, great job, Jimmy. That was so fun.
It's not quite the classic of the day the Mary and McAllister played at the
Academy. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll hear that again someday.
Yeah, maybe you play that. I'd like to hear that. You can play that next week or something.
Yeah. That's a classic song.
It is.
Absolutely.
Oh, I'll do this. I was going to put that down there. I'll go over here.
Oh, all traveling right. Man.
He certainly is a traveling man. Yep.
Yeah.
traveling just between songs.
Yeah.
All right. Is that audible? I have my sound on.
Yeah, it's all good.
Yeah, you're good.
Is the picture good?
Yeah.
Picture's good.
I can't see me because I follow Bob's lead, Cowboy Bob's lead. I don't have my screen on. I don't see me.
Yeah. Oh, well, we see you.
We're happy to see
and
you.
And we like what we see. Yeah.
Parker. Tomorrow. What's that?
Parker, how's Parker?
He's good. He's right there, not giving a wink.
Good.
I love you, buddy.
Give him a hug for us.
I will. Thanks all right. For asking. Tomorrow is the birthday, St. Patty's Day, of one of my best friends, Mr. Nathan Weldon. And Nathan is one of the first people I met in the San Diego music scene and is a huge inspiration and influence on me, and an amazing singer-songwriter. And he's exceptionally kind when I go see him to play, to now and again invite me up to play a song. And quite often when he does, he really likes one particular song that I play and asks if I would mind playing that, and I do not mind because it's my favorite song ever. So Nathan, this is for you on your birthday, from John Denver. And so you speak to me of sadness and the coming of the winter. The fear that is within you now, it seems to never end. And the dreams that have escaped you, and the hope that you've forgotten. You tell me that you need me now, you want to be my friend. You wonder where we're going, where's the rhyme, where's the reason, and it's you who cannot accept. It is here we must begin to seek the wisdom of the children and the graceful way of flowers in the wind. For the children and the flowers are my sisters and my brothers. Their laughter and their loveliness will clear a cloudy day, like the music of the mountains and the colors of the rainbow. They're a promise for the future and a blessing for today. Though the cities start to crumble and the towers fall around us, the sun is slowly fading, it's colder than the sea. It is written, from the deserts to the mountains they shall lead us. By the hand and by the heart, they will come for you and me. In their innocence and trusting, they will teach us to be free. For the children and the flowers are my sisters and my brothers. Their laughter and their loveliness will clear a cloudy day. And the songs I am singing are a prayer for non-believers. Come and stand beside us, we will find a better.
Gorgeous. I guess that's our favorite John Denver song.
Yeah.
Thank you for doing it, Jimmy.
Thank you.
Jimmy. One of my favorites, too. Thanks for doing it.
It's a beautiful song, and Jimmy does it so well.
He does.
Jimmy Lunsford.
Yeah.
Good to be with you guys.
Great to have you back in our time zone.
Yes,
Jimmy.
Yeah.
Hope the job works out to be great.
Yeah. And if you ever get up in our neck of the woods, you can always stay here.
Thank you very much. That would be awesome.
We can say Jimmy Lunsford stayed here, and Marianne McAllister too.
Right. We got Karen now.
We got Karen now.
Woo-hoo.
There she is. How's it going?
Good. So if I say President Pinocchio, you know who I'm talking about, right?
Yes.
Hell yeah.
Okay. So I'm not going to write any more songs about him, but I'm willing to recycle old songs I wrote about him.
Good.
All right.
Hey, folks.
Good. Wait, we gotta welcome you.
This is Karen Sauer.
Karen.
So, of all the things he's said that you would think would get him, you know, gone, the thing that got me the most was when he was in Arlington National Cemetery and he was with the father of a boy who was buried there and what he said. And if you don't remember, it's at the end of my song. So this is called President Pinocchio, and I'm going to do it to a track I made, which I put on my phone, which will connect wirelessly to this little speaker thing and join my voice in the microphone and then go into the computer. What could possibly go wrong? But this is President Pinocchio. Let's see. Now listen up, I'm gonna tell you about former President Pinocchio. He's a liar. When he said he was running 8 years ago, we thought it was a joke, but not a funny one. Then he got elected and there was a collective, holy smoke, oh no! Then he got rejected, but the dude won't go. Puppet Master Putin is pulling the strings. The Proud Boys are waiting in the wings. They're making sure that freedom don't ring while Ex-Pres Pinocchio sings. They're out to get me. It's fake news. It's a witch hunt. I do whatever I choose. Ain't no waking from this nightmare because I can't get to sleep. Puppet on the ballot gives me the creeps. Come on, ask yourself, is this what we get? A dictatorial marionette? I'm looking for the button that says reset, because we're living a game of Russian roulette. And people, we ain't seen nothing yet. Puppet Master Putin is pulling the strings. The KKK is waiting in the wings. They're making sure that freedom don't ring while past Pres Pinocchio sings. They're out to get me. It's fake news, a witch hunt. I do whatever I choose. The puppet incited an insurrection, but it is what it is. Let's talk election. Can he rule from jail? Under discussion. Is the Trump card held by the Russians? Vladimir's got something on him, you bet. Because the Donald's just a boy who can't say niet. Puppet Master Putin is pulling the strings. Crazy QAnon is waiting in the wings. They're making sure that freedom don't ring. And the passé prez? Picture him at a grave in Arlington National Cemetery where he says to the father of a boy buried there, I don't get it. What was in it for them? So if you're still listening, please take note. You gotta vote. Get him out of our heads and off of the news. Get him out of here. It's time for us to choose.
Yeah. Oh.
Whoa.
Great. Yes, indeed.
Awesome.
Thank you for that.
Karen, that was brilliant.
We needed that. Yes. So folks, vote. And if you know somebody that doesn't have a car or someone who's crippled or something like that, drive them to the polls or get them an absentee ballot or something. Something in addition to voting. Because this is probably the most important election of our lives.
Yeah, we thought the last one was, and it was until
this. I think they're all important. We just got to keep going till it's over.
Yep. Can't get tired.
You know, can't give up. That's right.
Karen, that was so cool.
Yes. What else you got?
So kind of on theme of what. What is it? You can't do anything wrong day?
Can't do...
Whatever I do is right day.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is Grammar Ain't What It Used To Be about the pronoun, the singular they pronoun, which all makes some people uncomfortable. Yes. Okay. They is among us, they is here to stay. Even Merriam-Webster likes the singular they. They's a pronoun for the non-binary, them that are neither he nor she. Maybe it don't sound grammarly, but grammar ain't what it used to be. If you find they perturbing, it might be less disturbing if you use it with a plural verb. That's allowed. Now listen here, for the genderqueer, times are tough, but it's easy enough for yous to use the pronoun they choose to be, in deference to gender fluidity, 'cause grammar ain't what it used to be. They is among us, they is here to stay. Even Merriam-Webster likes the singular they. They's a pronoun for the non-binary, them that are neither he nor she. Maybe it don't sound grammarly, but grammar ain't what it used to be. Now let's go back in time and talk about Ms. Way back in the 20th century, we said grammar's not the boss of me. Decided it was no one's biz if a gal ain't married or if she is. Most of us got used to Ms. Some still don't get it, but gee whiz, it's even in the OED. 'Cause grammar ain't what it used to be. Ms. is among us, she ain't going away. And it looks like singular they is likewise gonna stay. They's a pronoun for the non-binary, them that are neither he nor she. Maybe it don't sound grammarly, but grammar ain't what it used to be. Now let's look farther back. Or is it further back? I am I and we are we. You're you, but you didn't used to be. Until the 19th century, you were known as thou or thee. It's an etymological mystery, but that's how it was in history. And some still refuse to see that grammar ain't what it used to be. Thou hast left the building, fare we well, we say. And I'm almost done singing about the singular they. They's a pronoun for the non-binary, them that are neither he nor she. Maybe it don't sound grammarly, but grammar ain't what it used to be. So what if it don't sound grammarly? They is part of my family, and love trumps grammar any day. That's why I use the singular they.
Right.
Awesome.
Well done.
All in my mind here.
And you and I should talk about that soon. Not right now, though. Because it's not just grammar. Yeah. But anyway, I guess it's that I just don't like being told what to say. You know, but let's talk about it, because I see your point. I really do.
Do you like getting called what you're called?
You wouldn't be saying.
I don't care what you call me. And I think also that none of us are either he or she, that there's a bit of he in every she and a bit of she in every he, right?
Yeah, I agree. Okay.
You wouldn't agree be on saying it. Anything if somebody didn't teach you what to say.
I'm sorry?
Does that make us a we, Steve?
You wouldn't be saying anything at all if someone didn't teach you what to say.
That's true.
Good enough.
But you either accept it or you don't. All right, enough of this.
Thank you, Karen.
Karen Sauer, they're great.
They are.
Yes. All right, now before we get on to Cowboy Rex and Steve Azzaro, and we don't have Paul Clark anymore because he already played.
And Lisa will be after.
Lisa Walker, yeah, will be after Steve, and then Joe Isaacs, and then Freddie K.
And Joe isn't here yet, so we'll see about Joe.
Okay, we certainly will. But right now, we got to talk to Jade and Marianne. Two of our favorite legumes. Hey, Jade.
Hey, Jade. Sorry you hurt yourself.
Yeah, what, you cut your finger?
No. Oh, yeah, you do.
Yeah, I did.
I can't hear. How did you do that?
No, I cut my finger.
Well, it's nice not to be able to see either of you, but
or hear you.
Get a nice picture of the window. I'm always complaining.
I don't even know exactly how this happened. That's the weird thing.
Okay.
I'm just missing a big piece of skin all of a sudden.
Yikes!
Yeah. How are you?
I'm good. I broke a couple of ribs. One, anyway. I did.
Really?
I don't lie.
He's in a lot of pain.
It was a freak accident in the gym.
In the gym?
You know, there's the bicep machines.
Yeah.
And there's a pad, a support that you.
Yep. I know what you're talking about.
Put your upper arms on. And mm-hmm. I was reaching down to move the little pin.
Okay.
There, up to a lighter weight. Mm-hmm. And I shouldn't have done that. I should have gotten out of the chair and done it because I leaned against the corner of that brace and I felt it go.
Oh.
And it's been painful ever since.
It comes and goes, yeah.
Oh, good.
A few minutes. I don't feel it at all right now, but a few minutes ago it was awful.
Yeah. It was awful. Sorry to hear that.
How long do you think it'll be before you can play?
I'm hoping heal. Maybe another week. It just happened on Friday, of course.
Okay.
yesterday. That was yesterday, right? Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Sometimes you can't keep track of the days. Kathy, how are your eyes doing?
Good. I got them both done.
Yeah.
I don't have to wear glasses anymore except to read. So I'm very happy with how it went. It didn't hurt at all. It didn't have any bad feeling.
Oh,
and
good.
They did a great job. So I'm very pleased. Thank you for asking, Jade.
I think she's going to do what I did. And because, you know, I got mine done.
I remember that.
But I need glasses to read.
Okay.
And the problem is, though, when I take them off, I either lose them or sit on them.
So
that's what works for me, and I think that's what you're gonna do.
That's probably what I'm gonna do too.
Yeah, get bifocals.
Yeah.
All right.
And Marianne,
now you gotta adjust to those too.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Yep. Yeah. When I first got these, I was going.
Yeah.
You get the sweet spot.
It takes a little
adjustment. All right.
It's all good.
Yeah. Marianne. Hi.
I know.
And you're still working at home? In other words, you don't get down to the center much anymore?
I get down at least twice a week.
Nope, can't hear you.
Move the computer.
I get down at least twice a week.
Oh, okay, good.
Yeah, Wednesdays and Sundays. Other days if they need. The rest of the week, I work at home.
Every day?
Just about.
Yeah, they work you so hard, you know. And I say, well, this is your job, and you learn that job. And I say, oh, well, this is your job, too. Yeah. And then you have to learn it. Am I right?
Yeah. It's okay, though. It's important to the people that call and have the pets, you know.
Yeah. It's important.
It is,
you do
yeah.
important work.
And it's easier to do from at home because then you can sit and cry with them and they don't have to see you crying.
Yep, but I know what you mean.
Yeah. So,
have you seen the little fox?
No, not yet. Not yet. Hopefully. I forgot we had him. I learned last week, but I don't think I was in the building when I learned. So maybe tomorrow.
Yeah, good.
Yeah.
I remember one that we had a few years back, and they get the mange,
yeah.
which is scabies. And this particular guy had lost every single hair on his body, and he was silver from head to toe. But we nursed him back to health, and he was fine. And yep. we let him go. And then, yep. you know, chances are, because it's endemic, that he was going to get it again. But what we do is just give him a leg up.
Yeah.
A chance.
Yeah. Give him a chance.
It is. And it's almost a miracle to see the change in them, because I think I still have pictures of one of them where the face was just so, it was so horrible. It was like bubbly and everything.
Right.
And then to watch the transformation yeah. to become so healthy, it was unbelievable. You wouldn't know it was the same animal.
Right. Yeah. It took a long time too.
Yeah. 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 Well, so.
All right. Well,
another example of the great work at the New England Wildlife Center.
Yep. Yeah. So we'll see you on Wednesday.
That's right. Yep.
Yeah.
Here. Hopefully we'll both be there.
What time?
Yeah, I hope.
I don't remember, but it's semi-early. It's
I think
it's
yours doable. Was at 11.
Yeah. Oh, okay. That's yeah. later.
I'll be sending you out a text on good. Monday.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah. Great. We'll see, great. You, see you then.
See you then.
All right, all right guys. Thanks so. For joining us.
All right.
Thank you.
Bye-bye, y'all. All right, now it's time for Cowboy Rex.
Cowboy Rex.
And then Steve Azzaro, then Lisa Walker.
What's my problem here?
The only one showing up is Lisa at the moment.
Well, you can't find him. There he is.
Well, no, he's there, but he doesn't have his...
Steve left a BRB message.
Yes.
Oh, did he? Okay.
Steve, yeah. Oh, here's Cowboy. Now he's on.
Yeah,
there he is.
Hey, Cowboy. Right. Hey, Leah. Hey,
Leah.
Say how hi, you doing?
Say hi, Leah.
All right. You kind of did.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, kind of did.
And she does this. I've noticed, Cowboy.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I love it. All right. Put your little hands together for Cowboy Rex.
Speaking of pretty blue marble, here we go. Walking by the seashore in the sand, seagulls crying overhead. I found a message in a bottle, and this is what it said. I am alone and I'm scared. No one's looking after me. If you find my message, please, won't you come and rescue me? Well, I'm driving to work and I'm late again, catching every red light on the way. There's a ragged man on the corner holding up a sign, and this is what it says. I am alone, and I'm scared. No one's looking out for me. If you read my message, please, won't you come and rescue me? I saw a picture of the Earth from space, pretty blue marble floating peacefully. Clouds in the picture seemed to form a face. This is what she said to me. I am alone and I'm scared. One's looking after me. If you hear my message, please, won't you come and rescue me? I'm just one little tiny man, I said. How much can I really do? Be a good neighbor, be a friend, she said. It must begin with you. Walking by the seashore in the sand, seagulls crying overhead. I found a message in a bottle, and this is what it said.
Beautiful.
I think of love as a not only a feeling but also an action. That last song had a kind of a sort of a lady in it. This song has a lady in it too, so kind of sort of fits. Was a man who loved to ride all night long in the pale moonlight, singing to the stars. He was singing songs of love, and the night breeze and the hoot owls and coyotes sang along. Willa'd just like to stay at home, reading by the firelight all alone and dreaming. She was dreaming dreams of love. And her mantle clock and the treasures in her hope chest dreamt alone. Red met Willa at a town hall meeting. They seemed to see things eye to eye. Well, he was tall and shy, and she was apple pie and let her front door. She said, would you care to come in and talk some more? Red built Willa a home of her own, outside of town on the prairie land, where he loved to ride out in the pale moonlight. Now she sits by the window and listens to him singing to the stars. Yeah, she says at her window and listens to him singing to the stars. Ooh.
That's really beautiful.
Oh boy, Rex. Yeah, use a double negative. You can't not write beautiful songs.
You guys are nice.
Thank you, Cowboy.
Thank you, Cowboy. Ivy said to say goodnight to you, but she was getting too nudgy and she couldn't stay.
I heard her chirping. I chirping at me before.
Oh, yeah, okay. You call that chirping. I call it squawking. But
right.
She's like the rain bird. You know, hey, I'm squawking here.
Yeah, right.
Get it?
Yeah. You have an interpreter? do you have an interpreter?
Interpreter.
Interpreter.
Uh-huh. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. We could go on and on.
Yes, all but right. We won't.
Thank you, Cowboy.
Thanks again, Cowboy. Bye, Leah. I think Steve is next. I believe he is. So Steve will be next, and then Lisa, and then Joe, and then Freddie. And Steve writes, life is a puzzle. It's hard to understand the meaning, but good to be here.
You got it.
True and true.
True and true.
And he's got the Catbird Band behind him there.
Yep.
All right.
Oh, he disappeared.
It's a little there band.
There it
little
is.
Banjo.
Yes.
All
yes.
Right.
All right.
Oh, gosh, folks. Put them together for this guy. He's another great songwriter and activist, Steve Azzaro.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. This song that I've been working on doesn't have any melody yet. It's got lyrics, which I'm still working on, but I wanted to read it to you tonight. This is sort of a cappella without any notes. The title of it is called Echoes of Freedom.
subtitle, As One Shouts, So One Will Echo. And two definitions. Matrosia means Mother Russia, and Spasiba means thank you. Echoes of Freedom. Matrosia, please change our destiny. Help us to become free. Mother Russia, please make a new day. And remember all of those that were stolen away. Remember in the quiet waters the devil dwells and is making our lives a living hell. Matrosia sheds sad tears on the stagnant weeds that all should fear. Spasiba, Alexei, defender of us all. Thank you, Alexei, for standing tall. Spasiba, Alexei, the honest voice, urging all to make the choice. Freedom burns mightily in people's hearts. Matrosia, please do your part. Fearless souls defend human rights and defy the tyranny of the night. Beware the terror of evil corruption and the fierce winds of destruction. Echoes of those who took a stand, seeking truth in the homeland. Spasiba, Alexei, defender of us all. Thank you, Alexei, for standing tall. Spasiba, Alexei, the honest voice, urging all to make the choice. Evil active measures, we know, laid many a good man low. But their memory and bravery and words will help us rise out of slavery. Although flowers on cobblestones lay and candle flames gently sway, Russians now have open eyes. Hopefully we'll speak out and make a new day. Spasiba, Alexei, defender of us all. Thank you, Alexei, for standing tall. Spasiba, Alexei, the honest voice, urging all to make the choice.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you for sharing.
That's going to be great.
Yeah. Wow. Thank you.
You know, I do that a lot. I used to. I'd write the lyrics. I'd come up with the guitar part for it, but it would have no melody, and that was okay. And then as I played the song over and over again, the melody slowly surfaced. You know.
Yeah, that's certainly one way, Stephen, and. You know, and the other singer-songwriters know that sometimes a bit of melody will come, and sometimes a phrase will come, and sometimes we need to work the lyrics out and then let it evolve till it says what we want in notes and in chords. And this one needs a little more development, but it'll be finished. But I thank you for that and listening to that poem at this point. And this song I'm going to do for you, the person that they're referring to, Danny Boy, I like to think of as Alexei. He's very, very special. And here's a young man who didn't come home either, okay? Oh, Danny Boy, the pipes, they're calling from glen to glen and down mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses fall in. Tis you must go when I must bide. But come ye back when summer in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow, 'tis I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Danny boy, Danny boy, I love you so. When winters come and all the flowers are dying, and I am gone, as gone I will may be, you'll come and find the place where I'm lying, and kneel and say an ave there for me. Danny boy, the stream flows cool and slowly, the pipes still call, they echo across the glen, weary mother sighs and feels so sad and lonely, for you have not return to smile again. And I shall feel the soft future above me, and tall my grave will warmer, sweeter be. For you will bend and tell me in peace until you come to me. Yes, I'll rest in peace till you come to me.
Oh, sweet.
Beautiful.
Nicely done, Steve.
Thank you.
That was what was missing.
Yeah,
that song.
Yeah, right.
That's
right.
Steve Azzaro.
It is
folks.
Steve Azzaro.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Lisa is next.
Lisa.
And then if Joe gets back, it'll be Joe. And if not, it'll be Freddie. So get ready, Freddie, just in case. He's got my favorite hat on. Hi, folks. It's Lisa Walker.
You're Lisa Walker.
This hat is signed by one of my favorite people. It's signed by Steve Azzaro. Thank you very much. So I've been going crazy lately. What's new, right? Thank you.
Yeah. Woo! Wow. Ragtime Lisa. Look at that thing.
Oh, Halo's going into orange and red, and I tried to back off. So I was worried about it.
Well, you sounded good. Your voice was not too loud.
Everything was good.
It sounded like the guitar was peaking. I was trying to back off.
Oh. It sounded great to us.
I just was worried, so I didn't want to do that. This one is like going straight in. The other one is not.
Okay.
Hold on a second. Can't get there from here. You gotta go this way. that one. Now I'm back. I'm here. There's more than one way to switch a guitar. Woo! Well, I'm tired now.
Yeah.
I'm also quite thirsty. It's really hard to follow all you folks. Y'all are so wonderful. I want to go back and listen to all this again, you know.
Good stuff.
I've switched now. I'm acoustic now. Totally acoustic. Can you hear that guitar right?
Yes.
Thought I saw you walking in a crowd the other day. You know my blue sky's falling. You showed me the way to hide. thought I saw you walking. There's another picture of you.
Love that song.
Yeah, me too. That's wonderful.
Yep. Lisa Walker.
Lisa.
We can't hear you, but.
I said, I'm still reworking it, and one of these days I'll have it right where I want it. It's not.
Yeah, yeah. We've seen little changes to it as time goes by.
I'm working on it. It's going to. It's going to be better when I finish it.
Well, it's a beautiful song. It's a wonderful song. And you know, it's you. You do it so good.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Really.
Thank you, Frank.
Thank you, Karen.
Karen?
I'm sorry. Karen just is.
You're welcome.
Sorry.
All right. So Joe's not here.
No Joe.
Neither is Dave. But anybody get that? No. Dave's not here?
I got it. Okay. I was going to say it if you didn't.
Thank you. All right. So it comes down to Betty. There he is.
He is.
What's going on?
Say it ain't so, Joe.
All right.
I really wish I could play that song. I love it, but I'm not that good at it. One of these days, I'm going to play it.
Hey, practice makes perfect.
Say it ain't so, Joe. Please say it ain't so. By Murray Head.
Hey. All right, folks. Are you ready for Freddy?
Ready for Freddy.
Hold on to your pretty pink panties, because it's Freddy K.
All right, I got my Joey Mars Celtics hat on. My son's a Joey Mars freak. He's got Joey Mars stuff tattooed on his head and everything. So this is a special hat he made for my son. I guess it's pretty St. Paddy's, Celtics, and whatnot. So I try to do a little themey. And I'll play this one song. It's probably the closest thing I have to an Irish ditty. It's on on the White Album, my first album, Immortally Wounded. It's a short little song on that. I don't know, it's under 2 minutes. But, I might drag it an extra instrumental or so, but it's called Happy Go Lucky. Thank you.
that's what I am. Lucky guy, that's what I am. Just happy-go-lucky.
Oh. Never played that here before.
That's right after No One Grows from the Rain, like nuclear rain coming down. So I had to brighten things up on the album a bit.
Yeah, huh?
My bipolar is riding from destitute to illogical happiness. Okay.
Okay.
It used to be fun in your 20s. It was out then. Now I just have to think of 150,000 years from now, I can kick back and this will all just be frivolous and laughable.
Okay, if you say so.
That's what I'm saying. I'm sticking to it. Suffering succotash. But in the meantime, I really did not liquidate enough prior to. Powerade Zero, because I feel like a real Albert. Zero. Prince Albert in the can? Okay, let's get rid of Joey Mars. We'll go back to Freddie King. Okay. This song is called Sandbags. Written, I can't see what year it was written. Let's see. I think I tore it off. It was written September 8th of some damn year. 2010. So it's 14 years old at this point. Almost 14 and a half. Sandbags. Wanna sit back on my laurels. See if I can get into sit back on my laurels. I don't wanna write no new songs. Just wanna pull a chain on the light switch. I wanna deal with right and wrong. Just wanna sit back on my laurels. Don't want to write no new songs. Just want to pull the chain on the light switch. Don't want to deal with right and wrong. But the river is moving so strong. It's threatening the whole. Hold on, time. And as I sit here, using my sandbags for a footstool, should I watch the whole damn thing go down? Should I watch the whole damn world? I find comfort in my own insignificance. I know what will be. I try to do unto others as I'd like them to do to me. It's moving so strong. Shit is threatening to hold on town. And as I sit here using my sandbags for a footstool, should I watch the hold down thing? Down. I don't want to be labeled no preacher man. Maybe just a dope fiend gone wrong. Living between reality. Just waiting on the next song. Shit, it's moving so strong. Fuck, man, it's threatening. It's threatening. Hold on, Tom. And as I sit here using my sandbags for a footstool, watch the whole darn world. Wanna sit back on my laurels. Don't wanna write no new songs. Just wanna pull the chain on the light switch. Don't wanna deal with right and wrong. I find comfort in my own insignificance. I know what will be. Should I try to do unto others? I'd like them to do to me. Don't want to be labeled no fucking preacher man. Maybe just a dope fiend gone wrong. Living between reality. Just waiting on the next song.
Freddie, you just muted yourself. Freddie, you muted yourself. Freddie. Freddie, you're muted.
Fine.
Take us through the last verse again.
Threatening the whole down town. And as I say, I use my sandbags for footstool. Should I watch the whole down thing go down? Should I watch the whole down world go down? Sorry about the interruption.
It's okay. You get excited like that. Yeah, the main thing that threw me about that song, the whole darn town.
Yeah, I was back in an era when I was not swearing.
Oh, okay.
I've relapsed badly, but I had about 10 years. I had about 10 years where I didn't swear.
Oh, I didn't know you back then. all right, folks, that was Freddie K.
Yeah, Freddie K.
Freddie, next week's suggested themes, and that'll be March 23rd. Actually, the 22nd is World Water Day. You know, water is important. We don't have enough of it. In fact, I have a mutual fund. It's a socially responsible, I can't remember anything, an SRI.
Socially responsible investment.
Investment, yes, in the Calvert World Water Fund. And, you know, I figured I'd pick up, you know, because I figured we were going to need more and more water in it. And the stock is going right through the roof. So that's the silver lining for that. So next Friday is the World Water Day. And it'll be close enough to spring that we can celebrate that. It's National Puppy Day. And it's Be Mad Day. Be mad. I don't know which mad that is, if it's angry or crazy.
It's hard to have National Puppy Day and be mad.
Yeah, difficult to be mad at a puppy.
Yeah.
Well, unless he sits on your pillow.
Right.
Which has happened. So I want to thank you, Freddie, for being you and doing what you do. I want to thank you, Lisa and Steve and Cowboy and Jade and Mary Ann and Karen and Jimmy and Val and Rich and Kathy and Emily and Jay and Bob and Beverly and Storm and Mark and John and Neil and Mary Ann and Tom and J-Nut and Betty and Andy and Mike and Glenn. Thank you all for being who you are and what you do. We hope to see you next week because we love you. And that's all there is to say, except, as the Lakota say, Mitakuye Oyasi, we are all related. And Wakantan Kanishiun, may the Great Spirit walk with you.
And with you.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks, the tubers on YouTube and the whole world.
Yeah.
Thanks,
love all. You guys.
Part of the community.
We love every single one of you.
It's a good family.
Back at you.
It's returned.
All right.
Good night.
Night all.
Good night all.
Night.